views expressed on this program are those of the hosts, guests, and callers, and are not necessarily those of the station, its management, or other advertisers. You're listening to Transformation Talk Radio.
The following audio is via a Skype call.
Welcome to Healthy Edge Radio with Amber Thiel. Living with power, passion, and purpose, Amber has dedicated her life to empowering women to honor and love their bodies. As founder of The Healthy Edge, she is now bringing her message to the airwaves. Tune in for breakthrough, empowerment, and education on how you can love your body, feel amazing, shift your mindset, and create real, lasting results. This is an opportunity for you to learn, grow, heal emotional blocks, and transform your lifestyle. Healthy Edge Radio starts now.
Yeah, hey everybody, I'm Dr. Patton. I get to hang out today with the amazing, powerful message today, Amber Thiel. Amber, oh my gosh, what a show this is going to be.
Yes, I hope everybody's ready. I hope we're ready. I hope they're ready.
Well, you know, this is, today's show is Coach Yourself to a Better Life. And let's start out of the gate. I don't know many people, at least that listen to this show, that aren't really looking for, striving towards a better life. And it doesn't always mean what we think it is. It's not always like, oh, I wish I had that $1 million. It's like, you know, I want a more efficient way to take care of my household. You know, things that will allow us or enable us to have and experience more joy and also more love. But first, we have to start with us, don't we?
Yeah, that's the hard part. We don't want to look at us, Dr. Pat. It couldn't possibly be us. It has to be our circumstances, our situation, the person that we married, the fact that our children don't listen, that we have a boss that doesn't understand us and appreciate us. No, that's the first place that we want to go. And it's just human nature to do that. So that we're diverting blame and we're preserving ourselves. And unfortunately, you can live in that place. You can live your whole entire life in that place, but you don't experience that joy and that love and that feeling of accomplishment and really living the life that deep down inside, you know that you're intended to live when you're constantly looking at things on the outside. So one of the things that I really realized in my journey was my life did not shift into a place of power and a place of abundance and love until I realized that I am the common denominator in my life. So all my failed relationships, all the things that haven't worked out, all the patterns that I keep seeing repeated in my life over and over again, I can put the blame wherever I want. But the bottom line is I'm the common denominator. Mm. And so the great part of that is not, oh, well, you know, I'm already beating myself up, Amber. You know, why would I go to that place? Well, the positive side is that we can change ourselves, right? We don't have control over other people. We don't have control sometimes over circumstances and what happens to us. The only thing that we have control over is ourselves. So for me, that was like, oh, this is so awesome because now I felt like I had control to actually cause a shift in my lifestyle. So I would just encourage listeners right now that whatever, you know, area that you're looking to improve, you know, the place that you're really struggling is that you really have to assess what you have control over. Mm-hmm. And so that's first and foremost, because if you're looking at a situation and you're trying to change, let's say your son that's moved out of the house and he's totally, you know, doing X, Y, and Z, and you're just sitting there stressing and, oh my gosh, I can't believe my son's doing this and whatever. When you assess that situation, you say, okay, what control do I have over this situation? You realize very quickly that you do not have control to change that other person. So in that respect, for some of us, we need to surrender some of the things that have been causing us grief and has been causing us to feel resentful or bitter or exhausted or depressed or just stuck. And that is just the place of surrender. And a lot of that is spiritual, you know, knowing who your creator is, like laying down your anxieties and your fears and really just letting it go. But if you have some control, you know, what do you have control over? You are the only one that you have control over. And so that's the place to start. And if it is an area of your life where you do have a lot of control, there are a lot of things you can do. There's a lot of things that you can shift. Then that's a really good place for people to come to this show that we're talking about today with that in mind. Because that's going to help lead them through.
Yeah. You know, there's a little old prayer. And, you know, there's a little old prayer. We call it a prayer. But, you know, what it is, it's almost like a mantra. And it is the age-old serenity prayer. Mm-hmm. And, you know, many people know the prayer from whether it's 12-step programs or, you know, whatever that is. But it is this idea of, listen, give me the serenity so that I can accept the things I can't change. And then change and then give me the courage to change the things I can. And boy, I'll tell you, those two things, that's like a 1-2 punch for transformation. You know, it sounds so simple, doesn't it?
Yeah, it sounds simple. It is definitely not that simple. I mean, it is that simple. It really is that simple. However, there is emotions that comes with it. There's awareness that comes with it. You know, our tendency is that we want to do something to fix ourselves and to fix our lives. And a lot of times, like I talked about before, it has to do with our circumstances. We want to fix our circumstances. We're going to change them. We want to change people. We want them to act a certain way so that we feel more appreciated. We want someone to say something though, so that we can feel more worthy or more loved. The problem is that we're going to spend our whole life waiting for that. Human beings were not designed and put on this planet to make us feel amazing. You know, people were not put here for that reason. You know, and there's a lot of really great how-to books out there. And Brian Clemmer, who's one of my mentors, he wrote that if how-tos were enough, we would all be skinny, rich, and happy.
Yeah.
And it's so true because there's so many great how-to books. I mean, how many of us have read a book and we have thought, oh my goodness, this is exactly what I'm going through. This is exactly what I need to do. And then we don't do it. We don't do it. We do not fall through. We go to like a big, huge, you know, event and we're like, yes, I'm going to change my life. So it isn't the how-tos. It isn't that we don't have things to do. It's why don't we do them? And that is an inward job. That is an inside job of addressing why. Why do I continue to keep repeating the patterns that is leading to my weight gain? Why do I keep gaining and losing the same weight over and over again? Why do I keep attracting the same type of man? That's an inward job. And until we do the job on the inside, the how-tos will never manifest because our actions come from our beliefs and who we believe inside that we are.
You know, my sister, and I think I've shared this with you. My sister died on a hospital floor at about 450 pounds. And what I've come to know about, let's just talk about eating for a minute, because we're not just talking about that. We're talking about a whole bunch of things today. But what I come to know about that is my sister totally understood what she was doing. And it didn't matter how concerned I was for her health. What I loved about my sister and what everyone loved about my sister when she passed, the blocks, people lined up four blocks long in Yonkers just to pay their respect. My sister loved life. And for her whole life, you know, she took a lot of criticism about her weight, all of the above. And I thought about this, you know, for today, Amber, and I thought, you know, I'm so glad some of that rubbed off on me. But honestly, I so often think about how many times we believe as individuals, other people are A, trying to control us, and B, we're trying to control them. And this is dance now.
Yeah. Yes. And whenever we try to control, it's because we have a desire that's not being met. We're trying to control the situation so that we feel a certain way. We feel safer. We feel loved. We feel worthy. And these needs that we have that are not met a lot of times comes out in control. That's exactly where we go. So not only are people trying to control us so that they can get what they need, but we're trying to control other people so we can get what we need. So how great would it be for us to be able to love people more, need people less, which is my motto this year, love people more, need people less, and for us to find a way to meet those needs, to coach ourselves, to get ourselves in a space that we really can do what we've been called to do on this earth. And people don't like this word, but I'm going to use it. We are here to serve. Mm-hmm. We are here to love people and to help people have better lives and to show them like what it looks like to truly walk in compassion and empathy for each other. And if the world operated like that, we would all be so happy. We would all be so joyful because there is no greater feeling than helping another human being. We all know it is like a drug. It is addictive. But for some reason, we feel like we're going to miss out for something for ourselves if we do too much of that. And it's a lie. That's a lie that I want to break off. And I want to help people today really coach themselves and get themselves in the position that they don't need a lot from other people. Like they can find that source of power within them, you know, and be able to really live out fully their purpose, mm-hmm. which is mm-hmm. not about them. Our purpose is not about making ourselves happy. We will become happy in turn by fulfilling our purpose. We in turn will be happy and joyful and peaceful.
Yeah. One of the things I love about this, and let's talk about this when we come back from break. I don't know that I'm different than the folks listening to the show today, but I have always tried to really suck it up and do things on my own. This is one area, this inside job thing. I have found more than anything else that I need the help of someone to, if nothing else, be a solid, honest reflection. Because sometimes we can't see ourselves, can we? We can't see ourselves. You know, we don't really wake up today, you know, in a day and say, oh my gosh, you know, I'm so controlling today.
Yeah. Yeah. I think some of my clients, you know, the reason that they choose to work with me is they will say, oh my goodness, nobody has ever said that to me before, mm-hmm. but I know it's so true. Like that is the quality of a friend or a coach or a mentor that we need to have those type of people in our lives that from a place of love, I mean, sincere love, say, I need to tell this to you because this is a truth that we can't see because we're too close. Mm-hmm. And that's why clients want to work with me is that it's brutal honesty from a place of love to only help that person break through and get to a place that's someplace different. Cause if you can't see it, and no one ever tells you, some people will never find it. Like you won't find it. You won't even know that it's right there in front of your face because we just become oblivious to it. So some of the harshest things that people have ever said to me from a place of love have been the things that have just knocked me back on. But they have allowed me to grow more than people saying, Amber, you're so great and you're so amazing and just telling me the things that I want to hear. When people tell me the things that I need to hear, those have been the things that have really stimulated growth. And we can learn how to do this with ourselves, but for most of us, we're not far enough in that journey that we're able to look at ourselves through a set of lenses that isn't rose-colored.
Yeah. You know, I love it. When we come back, we're going to talk about get a better life by asking better questions. Amber Thiel is going to be talking about this because this is super important. You know, the other thing I think it's great to kind of ask all of you listening today is, you know, surely there's a path you can go on that will take you much, much longer in walking down that road trying to figure things out yourself. The path we're talking about today and what Amber is really suggesting and has put together in a fabulous retreat and program she's going to talk about today as well is why do that when we can accelerate our progress, accelerate our change, and accelerate the juiciness in our lives? When we come back, we're going to talk about these powerful questions and Amber's going to give us a sneak peek at what she's planned. Stay tuned, everybody. We'll be right back.
Winning at the game of money. Lynn Brown is now offering Full Spectrum Finance, a progressive 12-month program that will help you to navigate through the mechanics of financial expansion. Finally, a financial planner who looks at the full spectrum of money and abundance. Engage you in the mental, physical, and energetic aspects of finance. This is Full Spectrum Finance. Are you ready to get into it? For more information, go to fullspectrumfinance.com.
How would you like increased health and vitality? How would you like to avoid the onset of disease as well as slow the aging process? This is all possible through a simple, safe, and natural process. Every day, we are either moving toward wellness or away from wellness.
Hi, I'm Mary Jane Mack. I'd like to be your partner in achieving optimal health. Contact me now at MaryJaneMack.com or call 425-392-0659. Visit MaryJaneMack.com.
Best-selling author, spiritual life, and business coach Joe Nunziata brings his higher energy and no-nonsense style to people who are ready to make powerful changes now. Wake up, step up, power up with a shot of Joe. Join Joe the second and fourth Wednesdays at 3 p.m. Pacific, 6 p.m. Eastern for 30 minutes of high energy, no nonsense, and powerful tools to make powerful changes. Visit joenunz.com. That's joenunz.com.
Your happiness is your choice on Natural Peace Radio. Follow Sarah Van Rieswijk as she addresses the power of emotions. Each month, Sarah covers different topics as she helps listeners activate their energetic spark and create powerful energy and amazing opportunities. Manifest your desires with Natural Peace Radio. For more information on Sarah and her work, visit naturalpeaceliving.com.
Who's ready to rock 2018? Want expert assistance to ground and clear your energy and raise your vibration? Hi, I'm Wendy Rose Williams, certified spiritual teacher. Call 425-502-0362 to schedule your free 15-minute consult to learn how a one-hour soul wisdom healing session, full-day regression healing, or 90-day energetic boot camp can help you with the next big thing. Visit WendyRoseWilliams.com to plan your magic carpet ride with me.
Hi, this is Laura Richer, host of On the Verge Radio. Sometimes you hear encouraging messages like transform your life now, become empowered, create the life you crave, and it all seems overwhelming and you're not sure where to start. I'm here to tell you that self-improvement is not always fun and easy, but it is always worth it. The path to creating positive changes begins with releasing the things that have been holding you back. Then you can create a life that inspires you. I know this because I've done it. You can find out more about what I do by visiting my website, SeattleHealingHypnosis.com. I look forward to supporting you on your journey.
No, this is not goodbye. I swear that I'm gonna change. No, baby, please don't cry. Oh, it doesn't have to end this way.
Wow, thank you, Benny. That's beautiful. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Welcome back, everyone. It is just awesome to be connecting with all of you today. You know, the messages that I get to hear from the people, people like Amber Thiel joining me here today, they're powerful, but yet at the same time, what I know about them is they're needed. Amber, before we talk about asking powerful questions, I would love to have you update people, number one, how they can find out more about you, whether it's go to healthyedgeradio.com, or I know you're planning a retreat. Can you give us some information for our listeners today?
Absolutely. So healthyedgeradio.com is going to be the best way to see all the support that I provide, and we provide at the Healthy Edge. But for those people listening that have really had something laid on their heart to help other people, so whether it's women, families, you know kind of where your calling's at. And if you've had that passion to help women specifically in their health journey, which is an emotional journey just as much as it is physical, I am holding a 4-day retreat, and this is going to be in beautiful downtown Seattle, Washington. We have a beautiful, huge house that we all stay together with so that we can really just soak each other up. This is not just about becoming a health coach and practicing the skills, which is absolutely necessary for people to get into this field. You actually have to do it. And so we're going to be doing a lot of role playing, but we're also going to be doing a lot of fellowship and really supporting each other and creating what we love at the Healthy Edge with our coaches, which is a family environment. All of our coaches know each other. I know all of them personally, and we're on a mission. We're on a mission to help people be set free in their emotional and their physical health. And so this 4-day retreat, you leave with your health coach certification. You leave with a family of coaches that are going to be on this journey with you. You leave with the confidence and competence to be able to support someone on this journey with the Healthy Edge tools that we've created for your business and for your clients. And it's just a great way to say yes. I know there are women out there that's had this desire on their heart for a long time. You don't have to wait 6 months. You don't have to go through your program. You don't have to get a degree. You can spend 4 days with us. We have a lot of online support that you're going to be doing beforehand, and it's going to be amazing. And so typically our certification is almost $3,000, and we are offering a $995 special that includes a retreat. And it is to the first 5 people that join our Healthy Edge family. And I do like to meet every coach, Dr. Pat. This isn't something I'm looking for, like, masses numbers of people. I really want to make sure that this is the right fit for them and for us. So at healthyedgeradio.com, you'll see something at the very top that'll say learn more about this $995 coach certification that's happening in June. And you click on that, you can schedule a call with me. We get on the call. I want to hear about you and your life and your passion. And I'll share with you, like, how the Healthy Edge got started and what we do for health coaches. And then together we can make the decision if you're one of those 5 people. And I'm just believing that perhaps some of the listeners that have been listening to a few of the shows that you've done, you just think it's something different. And if you've been thinking about that and you keep tuning in, I would just encourage you to reach out. It's not a, you know, you're not automatically committing, but you're saying, you know what, I'm open and I'm willing to follow this desire that I have.
Yeah. And I think that's so important, because one of the things we hear from people a lot is that, you know, they've looked into coaching programs and they just don't feel that connection. And what I love about you, what you said, is it is important that we get to know the people that we work with, because we're engaging in a lifelong journey, not really a weekend. We're engaging in how to support each other so that we can support the world. And so thank you for doing that. Thank you so very much.
Well, thank you for offering a platform for me to be able to, you know, reach people that I wouldn't normally be able to reach. So it all works together.
Well, and, you know, part of this too is, how do we go about this and really get to the core of what's happening? And one of the things I know you do is you really explore asking powerful questions. I don't think there's anything more powerful than that. Tell me a little bit about questions. Now, a lot of times we're asking ourselves questions, but they're not really helping us, are they?
No. Our default is to go to, what is wrong with me? Why do I always do that? You know, why can't you get yourself under control? Like, this is so like you. You know, it's those tapes that we've heard perhaps from our parents or a critical person in our life. And they're the questions that take us to the place of we're not worthy and we're not lovable and those places. And so the first place that we start with our coach certification, and also just, again, and somebody who wants to be able to coach themselves through life, is asking questions. And coaches think that it's about telling people what to do. This is not about telling people what to do. People don't want to be told what to do. We are not a how-to book, right? Remember the how-tos? We can read books and the book tells us exactly what to do. And coaches want to tell people exactly what to do. Well, you just need to eat this and you should do that. And well, you need to tell that person that. That doesn't empower people. That puts people in a position that if they don't do what you say, or if they do what you say, it's not from their power. So we have to empower people just like we have to empower ourselves. And we believe as coaches that everyone has the power within them to discover their own solutions. It's already there. We just have to pull it out. And when you help people pull out the solutions within them, guess what? They own them. What happens when you own them? You actually do them, because there's power there. When someone tells you what to do, we can think back to our parents. How many people actually did what their parents did, you know, told them to do? Usually there was a threat involved. But when we came up with the idea, when we came up with the solution, when we came up with what we thought was, you know, the next step or where we wanted to go to school, what we wanted to major in, like, we were all for it. So we need to do that same thing with ourselves. And if you're a coach and you're listening to this, really thinking about how much time are you listening and asking questions, or how much are you talking and telling people what to do? Because that is the difference between a great coach and basically someone who's more of like maybe even a mentor. A coach is designed to pull the solutions out of people. So again, most people ask terrible questions. Now I'm going to give a very common example that's very superficial, but I think everybody can relate to it. So Dr. Pat, let's say that you're on a health journey. I mean, you're feeling incredible. It's Wednesday. You've been to the gym every day this week. You've ate your oatmeal, you're drinking water, you're eating your salad. I mean, you are like unstoppable. And then your girlfriend calls up and she's having some issues. And she says, oh, can we meet at our favorite Mexican restaurant? So you meet at the favorite Mexican restaurant. She's already got a margarita. As a matter of fact, she's on her second margarita. She's got a big plate of comfort food. You're right there with her. You're like, nobody drinks alone. So you have a margarita. Then you start eating the chips. And before you know it, you're like, ah, you blow it. You just order the enchilada deep fried with all the cheese. And you're just like, what is wrong with me? You're sitting in the car and you're like, what's wrong with me? Why did I do that? Why did I just sabotage this great, amazing week? Why did I let the emotion of my friend affect what I did? Oh, great. You know, I just did all this work. I probably just blew it. You're thinking about the calories. I mean, you're just going to this place of self-condemnation and it's just spiraling. And it's all these questions that are focusing on the things that we fear about ourselves and the things that we really believe about ourselves. That we don't have willpower, that we're not going to be able to do this, that when the going gets tough, we always fold. Mm-hmm. Oh, as soon as I have a little bit of success, I always self-sabotage it. Oh, I can't ever keep the things that I really want in life. I always find a way for them to slip through my fingers. So it's these questions take us to the place that drives us back to the beliefs that really don't serve us. And we go there so quickly. Some of us don't even realize that we're asking these questions. It's not like it's even a verbal, audible question. It's just we know we automatically go to that place of beating ourselves up. And it's because we're asking these questions. Now, unfortunately, some of you aren't going to want to hear this, but this is that certain emotions are comfortable. They're comfortable for us. And we love comfort. Our world is basically built around these beautiful walls of comfort that keep us in a place that is familiar to us. Now, comfort doesn't always mean that it feels good. That's what people don't understand with comfort. It doesn't always mean that these are like great emotions. It just means that it's familiar. So I want you to think about what emotions are familiar to you. But if you wrote them down on a piece of paper, you'd say, but I don't want those emotions. And most of us, it's things like we feel comfortable being weak. We feel comfortable being unworthy. We feel comfortable being overweight, being unlovable. And so when we start to feel these new emotions, like, hey, I'm on day 3 of eating amazing and I'm feeling empowered and I'm feeling confident, I'm feeling healthy. Oh my gosh, I'm feeling like I'm sexier and I'm like, I could actually like let somebody love me. I'm feeling worthy. Because it's outside our comfort zone, our subconscious wants to go back to where it's safe. It doesn't know these feelings. These are new feelings. These are not feelings that I'm used to feeling. So our subconscious wants to pull us back into that comfort zone. So we skip a workout. We eat a whole pizza by ourselves. We drink a bottle of wine. We call up that ex-boyfriend that we know we shouldn't be calling up. And we engage in relationships that we know is going to make us feel bad. Why? Because we want to go back to that place that is familiar. And that is why we self-sabotage. And these questions lead us right back to that place, right back to that place. And for some of you, you just need to identify where is the emotion after I do something that I know is not enhancing my life. It's not taking me anywhere different. what are the familiar emotions, even if I don't want to feel them, but what are they? Though that side is not bad. It just needs to be loved, and it needs knowledge, and it needs to be respected and understood. And then from that place, we can say, okay, I acknowledge you and I respect you and I get it, but I want to spend more time over here. So I'm going to understand those emotions, but I'm not going to stay there. So I'm going to ask myself questions that allow me to pull myself to the place that I really want to be, which is outside of my comfort zone, which when you spend enough time outside of your comfort zone, we know what happens, Dr. Pat, our comfort zone then moves.
Yes, it does. And that's really what we want to do here. You know, we want to do it. It's really interesting. I was talking to somebody the other day and I was saying, you know, I have this little stepper thing that I can do when I'm sitting because I do a lot of computer work. And so it's this little elliptical thing that if you're sitting down, you can literally do steps on it. And somebody said something to me like, well, that's not really going to make a difference. And I just said, well, wait a minute. What makes you say that? I said, you know, you can adjust. And I started to defend myself. And because we are willing to buy in to somebody else's belief about what is best for us or what would work. And I asked the question back, a little light bulb went on because I was looking at what we were going to talk about today. A little light bulb went on and I said, well, tell me a little bit about why you think it won't work. At that point, Amber, I was curious. Right? Because I know that if I use that little elliptical stepper when I'm sitting down, and it's a great one, I think this is just for senior centers, but I think every assisted living, any place where people have more time where they're sitting, every one of those places in every room should have them. And you sit down and you're moving and you're working. I will guarantee you that if you do 10 minutes, even on a slight resistance, and you're not used to sitting there for 10 minutes and cranking that thing out, your legs will get stronger. But we're so willing to argue for our limitations.
Yes. Yes. And it's just the mental. Even if you just do that, think about where it puts you mentally. Sometimes we do things just to create the foundation to how to walk through our day. So for example, some people get up in the morning and they stretch.
Yeah.
Say they do some deep breaths. They do a little bit of like gratitude. And some people say, well, like what difference does that make? It's 5 minutes. It sets the tone for the entire day.
Yeah.
Just when I wake up in the morning, I have my no cook oatmeal, which is my number one, you know, healthy edge tip that I give. I have my green smoothie. Now that takes me probably 5 minutes to prepare. But Dr. Pat, somebody else gets up and they spend their 5 minutes in line at Starbucks. Those two decisions will literally set the course for the whole day. The cravings, how you feel mentally, your energy, just the confidence that you have in yourself, the decisions that you're going to make later on in the day versus getting a muffin and a coffee versus spending 5 minutes to make your own breakfast. Like it's literally that big of a shift. So those little things do matter. People think that it's the marathons of life. It is not the marathons. It's the tiny little things that you think are so insignificant. Those things are the things that add up to big change. It's not the big things. We wait for these big things. We think we need to make these big decisions. We need to do these big changes. No. Our life is in the details. Our results are in the details. It's not what you do some of the time. It's what you do most of the time. And what we do most of the time are just making little decisions and having conversations with ourselves and making little choices that are significant when you put them all together.
Yeah. So what I love about this is these little decisions can have enormous impact. And I want to talk about that. Let's go ahead and skip the break so we can do that. Let's talk about it because we're now talking about looking at decisions we make today that in fact could heal our past. Mm-hmm. And we have this ideology about our past. And we used to think once upon a time, I was going to have to spend 10 years in therapy, and then maybe I was going to have to go get some other treatment. But now we know about the power of energy healing and energy and attitude. So let me ask you this question. You know, is the age-old view of my past is going to take many lifetimes to heal? How does that fit in to the paradigm we're talking about today?
Oh, this is huge, because as a coach, we are not a therapist. And very easily, it can feel like you're doing therapy with someone, because most people identify with the hurts of their future has originated in their past. So people want to go back there, and we call it their story. And we all have a story. And every time I get on a free breakthrough session with a prospective client, they tell me their story. How did they get here? And their story, they've not just told me. Their story, everybody knows. It's their reason why they have what they have in life. So usually it's around significant events. It can be around abuse. It can be around a marriage, a failed marriage. It can be around, I didn't graduate from college, therefore I'm XYZ. But there's some story, and there's usually a theme to it. And this story, people live and die by.
Yeah.
They live and die by their story. They operate in alignment with who the story tells them that they are. And our story is our version. That's what I want everyone to understand. It's our version of what happened. So if it's our version, that means that there are other versions. You know, they say that there's three sides to every story. What this person said, you know, what the other person said, and then there's the truth. Because it's just your version of the story. So what we have to help clients do, and what I would encourage you to help yourself do, is go ahead and write down your story. And I would write it down, because just thinking about it is not going to be powerful enough. And just saying it's not going to be powerful enough. You need to see it on a piece of paper and circle or underline the events, not the emotion around the event, not what you told yourself that the event meant about you, but just what happened. My mother died from cancer. I had to take care of my siblings, you know, because my father wasn't around. I watched my father beat my mother. I saw X, Y, and Z happen. I was addicted to crack cocaine for 10 years. I was an alcoholic, like whatever it is, with no emotion. Doesn't mean anything. It's simply what happened. That is the most important place that we can all start, because our story doesn't hold us back until we create meaning to it. Otherwise, it's just facts. And is it true? Is it not true that there are people who were raised in poverty, in, you know, gang violence, not even able, you know, bars on their windows, had friends and family, you know, murdered, like came from that type of environment in a poor school system, and actually rose up out of that, decided to not get into a gang, not get into drugs, study really hard, be a great athlete, get a scholarship or find a way to go to school and basically create a different life for themselves. And then there's another person in that same environment that decided to start selling drugs when they're 10 and just basically surrender to the fact that I can't change my circumstances. This is all I know. This is it. And they have a completely different life. Mm-hmm. It's just like two siblings that have the same exact parents. One becomes a lawyer. The other one becomes addicted to drugs. We see it all the time. Same upbringing, same parents, same everything, because we have the power. We have the power to give our power to our story. And where are we going to put the power? Mm-hmm. So for some people, if you've been held back with patterns in relationships, patterns with weight, patterns with jobs, patterns with, you know, succeeding and failing, like whatever it is in your life, I want you to look at your story and look at the events and ask yourself, what meaning did you attach when your husband left you? That you're not worthy, that you're not good enough, that you're not whatever, because I guarantee that you're going to attract another man into your life that maybe won't cheat on you this time, but is going to verbally abuse you this time. Because inside you believe that you're not worthy, you're not good enough. I mean, this is powerful stuff that, again, can feel like therapy. But from this place, this is how you rewrite your past to serve you. You can't change it, but you can definitely help it to serve you. And we were just talking about this, Dr. Pat.
Yeah, yeah.
Of being grateful, like how grateful I am. These last 2.5 years have been the most tumultuous 2 years of my life. I have had more growth in myself over the last 2 years, more than my mom's death, more than the $15,000 I spent on personal development and going to workshops and experiencing. It has been from the tragedies. And thank goodness that I've been able to write these last 2 years a story that empowers me, because for other people and where I was 10 years ago, this would have taken me down. Like, I would not have the power to be on this show talking to other women if I did not have these tools. And I'm telling you right now that these things have happened, these things have been done to me, but man, I am writing a story that serves me, that I'm going to rise up. I'm going to give this power to other women. I'm going to take more power for myself. I'm going to create something beautiful out of this and magnificent out of it, because God tells us in the word that all things work out for our good. And I am not going to allow this to dictate or to tell me who I am and who I am not. I choose that. Mm. And so this is the power. I mean, this is where you get your power back. If you didn't like your childhood because you were beaten as a child, guess what? As a child, you made up a belief in that moment that served you as a child. Because as a child, we do depend on grownups. And unfortunately, too many children are in situations where they are powerless. But guess what, ladies listening to this? If you have anything from your past as a child, you are now an adult. And you get to rewrite that story from an adult protecting your child self. And you get to write a story from a place of power now, of protecting that child and the things that you can do now that can counteract the damage that was done back then.
Yeah.
Whether it's giving to other children, whether it's writing a letter to the perpetrators or to whatever, like, you can take that power back. And that is where things start to shift for people, because once you let go of your story, anything's possible.
Yeah. And I think that's what we've learned. I mean, you and I both have taken the classes. We've done the human potential things. We have spent, you know, tens of thousands of dollars on exploring what's possible in our own world. And one of the things we now know, and now you're passing on to other people, is let us show you the way and let it not take 6 different lifetimes to get there. You know, but another part of this journey is learning how to set boundaries and what that means in not ending necessarily relationships, but building relationships beginning with you. Let's take a short break when we come back. Setting boundaries. Do you know what a boundary is? Because I got to tell you, I did not know. Amber Thiel in the house. We'll be right back.
Who's ready to shine in 2018? Hi, I'm Wendy Rose Williams, certified spiritual teacher, past life regressionist, Reiki master, author, and radio host. Want to bring your unique message on air with me as part of the Transformation Talk Radio Network and Soul Wisdom Radio platform? Call 425-502-0362 or visit wendyrosewilliams.com to learn how you can expand your reach by sponsoring or advertising with Soul Wisdom Radio.
The truth is funny. Shift happens with Colette Marie Steffen is excited to welcome Karen Benton as a monthly guest host. Tune in on the third Wednesday of each month at 8 a.m. Pacific time to regain confidence and trust in your capacity to create change in your life, your health, your family, and your well-being. Karen Benton is a mother, nurse practitioner, certified body talk practitioner, Franklin Method instructor, and owner of Limitless Living LLC. For more information about Karen, visit karenbenton.com.
Conscious Confidence Radio, a timeless wisdom with Sarah Maine. Tune in each month on Transformation Talk Radio and join Sarah on an adventurous journey to the deeper level of meaning to move beyond today's world of constant change, confusion, and uncertainty beyond the shadow of fear. This hit show explores key concepts such as confidence, values, and attitude in a dynamic way. To learn more about Sarah and her work, visit sarahmaine.com.
Did you know that all of the shows on the Transformation Radio Network are available as podcasts to stream or download?
Really?
Check us out. Go to transformationradio.fm. We have business shows, spiritual shows, energy healing shows, and pretty much everything in between. Something for everyone, guaranteed to inspire, educate, and transform. We are transforming the world, one listener at a time.
Introducing New Soul Science, an introductory course with Ruby Betty, offering profound wisdom alongside radically simple concepts and techniques that collapse time, allowing instantaneous personal transformation. The foundational techniques of this introductory course reveal the profound inner ability each human has to access and fulfill their individual soul script or soul promise. Awakening this ability leads to the mastery of one's destiny. The concepts are totally original, immensely powerful, and completely revolutionary. They ignite an infinite fire within each listener, fueling one's ability to live out their unique soul promise. Are you ready to become more aware and access amazing personal transformation? This course is available now at rubybetty.co.
Wow. Hey, everybody. Welcome. Welcome. Listen, it's so great to have all of you tune us in and turn us on. You know, first of all, let me welcome you today to the network, of course, but also to Healthy Edge Radio with Amber Thiel, living with power, passion, and purpose. You know, today we're talking about, you know, coaching yourself. How do you coach yourself to a better life? And we talked about these outward results being an inside job. And then we talked about the power of questions and how to use those questions to heal your past, how to do it in a way where you can activate the best of you instantaneously. But now this is a big topic. It's the topic of boundaries. It's the one thing that many of us struggle with on a day-to-day basis. Before we talk about this, Amber, one last time, how can people find out more about you and about your upcoming retreat?
So healthyedgeradio.com is where people can check out everything that we do to support women, men, their families on this emotional and physical journey to living your abundant life. So everything from online food prep workshops to a really powerful community of people that we support on a monthly basis. That's a great first step for some of you. We've got a free coaching session if you really feel this is a personal journey that you need to go on and you just want to learn more. And then for those of you that have had it on your heart to coach, but you haven't found the right system, the right vibe, the right whatever support that you're looking for. We are truly a family of men and women, mostly women, but we do have some guys that come together and we want to help set people free. And so I have a coach certification retreat coming up. You will spend 4 days with me and seasoned Healthy Edge coaches, as well as new Healthy Edge coaches in beautiful Seattle, Washington. For 4 days, you'll be immersed in coaching and planning and structuring your business. We teach you how to do a free coaching session to help, you know, open people up to the idea of working with you. And of course, you're going to leave with just an amazing group and network of coaches to be able to go on this journey with. So That is also at healthyedgeradio.com. And like I said before, I want to personally get to know anybody that wants to join our team. So you'll actually be on a call with me and we'll get to know each other and chat and see if this is a good fit for you.
Awesome. Thank you. Now, I know that we have a few minutes left here to talk about boundaries, and possibly in a future show, we can go into more detail. But really, the buck stops at the boundary line, boy. That's where the rubber actually meets the road. And it's a big topic, but very specific to today. There's some light that you could shed on this for folks to take in at this very moment and do something about.
Yeah, absolutely. First is understanding why we don't set boundaries. Our journey is all about awareness. You can't just give people how-tos without the awareness of patterns and why they've been doing things differently. So let's just bring awareness to the situation is that most people are afraid to set boundaries because they're afraid that they are ultimately going to push people away. And if they push people away, that means that they're going to be alone, which is one of our biggest fears as a human being, is to be alone. And of course, if we're alone, that means there's no one there to love us. So at the deepest, deepest core, even if you don't feel this in the moment, when you really get down to it, the reason we don't set boundaries is we are afraid that we're going to be alone and not loved, that we're going to be rejected. And so that is something just to be aware of, because it actually produces the opposite. You actually can get more love. You can get more people in your life because you have, you yourself are in a better state. And obviously when we're a better version of ourselves, people want to be around us. We start to have more authentic relationships. We start to have relationships that aren't about give and take and what you can do for me. Remember the motto, we want to love people more, need people less. So one of the biggest things for me personally that I share with my coaching clients and we share in the Healthy Edge program is inner circle, outer circle. Now, we all have people in our life. We have everything from relatives. We have friends. We have coworkers. We have our kids. We have our kids' friends. But it doesn't mean that everybody gets equal access, meaning that not everybody gets equal access to our time, to our energy, to our input, to our feelings and our thoughts. And so we have to be protective of that. And the great thing about the inner outer circle is people don't even need to know where they're at. So this isn't even something that you verbally have to tell someone. It's something that you implement. So an example is I have an outer circle where I have some relatives that are on the outer circle. What does that mean? When I get on the phone with them, we talk about the weather. It's amazing that you can talk about the weather for at least 10 minutes with people that are on your outer circle. I ask them about their life. I want to ask them about work. Everything's very superficial. And that is for protection, because I know that those people aren't equipped to support me in my dreams or to move me forward in the places that I'm trying to heal or in the places that I'm hurt. And so if I know that they're just going to take me to that negative place and they're just going to reiterate those beliefs that I'm acknowledging in myself, but that I'm not cultivating, then I move them to the outer circle. Same mm-hmm. I meet a new friend. We can have coffee. I usually have coffee then with two other people so that we're not one-on-one. It's just these strategies that you implement to either keep people inner or outer. Now, my inner circle, we share our dreams. We pray for each other. We lift each other up when something happens. You know, I'm going through something right now. It's like I've got my inner circle of about three people. And guess what, guys? It doesn't need to be 15. It actually shouldn't be 15. Women, you think that we need to have like 25 best friends. We do not. We do not. We need to have two or three people. And sometimes those people aren't even people that we see on a daily basis. Spiritual warriors with me.
Yeah.
They are women that believe the same thing I believe. We pray for each other. We know about each other's lives, but we don't necessarily interact on a day-to-day basis, but we stand in agreement with each other.
And you have each other's back.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So, there's nothing greater than that feeling. You know, it's beyond camaraderie. It is, you mentioned it before. It really is a fellowship of service and support.
Yeah.
It's
Absolutely.
Powerful beyond imagination. Amber, what a great show today. And I know that we're going to be talking about boundaries and all of the above as we move forward. I want to thank you for today and ask you, what's your personal message? And also, how can people find out more about you?
Thank you again, Dr. Pat. These shows are just all, before the store, the show, that this is just as much for me as it is for you. It's not about that I've arrived at any place. It's that I am on a journey. I'm committed to the journey, that I've learned that it is worth the journey to love myself. Because when I love myself in a pure way, I'm able to love other people. And so, this has just been a blessing to me as well. And my encouragement to you is to be held accountable, to find a way for you to be held accountable. These are great strategies for you to be able to implement, for yourself. But a lot of this comes with the background of going through the journey and doing enough work that you have a solid foundation. So if you feel like your foundation is very wobbly and you're like, Amber, these are really great ideas, but I just don't feel like I have enough strength on my own, is to find that accountability. So check out healthyedgeradio.com. There's a free coaching session available if you personally feel like you need some support. But if you're already kind of on the journey and you kind of feel like me, like you're on it, you're ready to bring people with you and you want to be the leader, please check out our 4-day retreat. We're only doing this one time in 2018, and this $995 offer with the retreat is over almost $2,900 value. So we are giving this away because I really do feel that we have five special people that are going to join our family and our mission for this retreat.
You've been listening to Healthy Edge Radio with Amber Thiel, living with power, passion, and purpose. If you've missed any part of this show, you can download the podcast at getthehealthyedge.com. Tune in live each month as Amber Thiel, founder of The Healthy Edge, joins Dr. Pat to create amazing conversations that will empower and inspire.
The preceding audio was via a Skype call.